This new executive order goes hand in hand with Thursday's expiration of the stay-at-home order. Now, I spoke with the owner of Foxton, which is just right behind me, about what this new executive order means not only for her and her business, but for all businesses across the basin.
But I do expect that will help. I mean, I think people are ready to get out and shop. And so I do think it'll help of people being able to come in and, you know, look for summer clothes for their kiddos.
However, businesses are not required to open if they aren't ready to do so. Foxton will follow the rules in place with one extra rule of their own involving hours of operation.
We're not required within our owner of Ally Village, the shopping center where I'm located, we're not required to be open a certain amount of hours like some developments are in the city. So really it's by choice if we feel comfortable opening back up.
And while Foxton seems prepared for summer sales, the fall is more concerning because they don't know how much of their new inventory they will actually get from overseas.
That's where you're going to see a lot of the impact in terms of what the availability is of the clothing that you purchased in advance for that upcoming season. Because a lot of our retailers have already reached out to us to let us know. We really don't know how much of your order that you placed you're going to get.
But the most important aspect of this new executive order for retail businesses is simply having people back in the stores.
I think anybody, having the ability to have anybody come in is going to be helpful. And the more and more that people get out and shop, you know, it's only going to go up from there. I mean, it'll absolutely help being able to be open at 25%, 50%, etc.
Now, this is only phase one of Governor Abbott's plan to reopen Texas. And if all goes smoothly and Texas does not see a spike in COVID-19 cases, then Governor Abbott could progress to phase two, which would allow all the businesses that opened up during phase one to increase their capacity limit while also allowing even more businesses to open up. But that is still at least a few weeks away. Live in Midland, Jonathan Palasik, News West 9.